What's that?
Weak.
Okay, weak, yes.
Anguish.
Anguish?
Yeah.
Okay.
Why? And
what? Why?
He's going, why?
That's right. He's looking up to the heavens, right?
Yeah.
Looking up to the sky.
And what are you going to do?
Torture, emaciated. Right? So how would I make that?
Hope.
Hope? Okay. Nice.
Yeah, see, the strength of his hands, too.
Yeah. So the speech. Okay, right. You're open. See, you know there's space in there.
Wow. I would add today, Ukraine.
So how would I make, you know, somebody asked if it's programmatic. So I might think in my mind there's something in the play that's going to represent looking upwards to the heavens, earthly hope, emaciated, suffering, it's a march. So I'm putting those things in my head right now. I don't even remember what I played on the last one, so, but something's going on there. Okay, so we'll see what we got here. This is a viola. Now, I just wanted to give you a peek into my process. There's a musician named Kenny Werner who has a book called Effortless Mastery. He published it in 1996. And the idea is more of a Buddhist approach to playing music. Instead of like trying to be good, I'm going to make this good. This is what most musicians are trying to do, if you know. You start from a place of every note is a divine expression. Even if I go like that, that's the most beautiful note in the world. So you start from that place. And that's how I make music just on the spot. And keep my, you know, what do they call it, the chatterbox, the critical mind back there. Actually, the more you practice this, the more it just doesn't appear. Because you accept everything that comes up, and then you can kind of shape from there what's happening. So it's cool that this says reconceiving failure.